Well, probably for now, and then in a second, I'll sit down. I guess it'll be, you know,
that's what you care for, thinking it knows, let it go. Down to Thank you. stuck around all the same. Nothing left to do. What is there to do? You face the truth. It's over now. We're all through. It's over now. Nothing left to do. Call it a day. It's over now. What is it to do? You face the truth. 'Cause it's over now. We're all through. It's over now. Nothing left to do. Call it a day. It's over now. It's over now.
This next one, I got inspired by the Beach Boys. It's gonna sound kind of corny, but I've been watching Full House for a long time, and I had
nothing says rock and roll.
Yeah, no kidding, right? Hey, if Uncle Jesse can be rock and roll with all those kids around, so can I. Anyway, so I've been watching, you know, this show for a long time, and my first real experience with the Beach Boys was actually with the movie Cocktail, when they were in Kokomo. And I thought it was pretty catchy, whatever, whatever. So that was like 1988. I was like, how old was I in 1988? Well, I don't remember. But anyway, so fast forward all these many years later, and I'm watching this TV show that I love on Friday nights, and imagine my surprise when this Beach Boys song comes on. So, you know, over the years, I've been wanting to learn how to play it and whatnot. So finally get the opportunity to play it a couple years ago. I think we debuted Forever, a cover of Forever that we do here. I think it was about 2 or 3 years ago. So I got inspired just off of the version that I found online. I was like, well, take this and take that, and I can do something with this. I'll leave that B flat out because it sounds kind of funny. But anyway, so I just started writing songs, and it's one of my first proper songs that I wrote. At least the music is great, so hope you guys like this one.
To wash away all the memories we've made. Moving on, I put the past to bed. No more living with regret. color of my love for you.
come back to life.
Thank you. So this next song is, as John was inspired by Full House, I was inspired by a Hallmark movie to write this one, because sometimes, you know.
All we need is inspired by a Lifetime movie.
Well, that Mark was going to write that one. Oh, yeah. But I was watching this movie and I said something in there and I can't remember what it was, but they were talking about just, you know, things that didn't fit together but did. So as I was watching it, one of the characters said, "A little grace is better than none." And so I thought, huh, like that's... It's deep, like to me it was deep, and to you it was deep, but I thought that, and so I came up with thinking of something that didn't fit, and I thought, well, Love in a Hurricane kind of sounds different. So, anyhow, I'm going to do it.
next song is kind of Springsteen inspired, not so much lyrically or even the style. It's more of a, I wanted to write a song that I thought maybe Bruce Springsteen, kind of like what he would write. By the way, if you haven't checked out Springsteen on Broadway, it just came out. It's pretty awesome. I've only checked out the audio. I'd like to check out the actual video of it. This is my tribute to Bruce Springsteen in a way, so hope you guys like it. I've been playing it for about a year. So just don't tell me.
Thank you.
This next one's fairly new. We wrote it about a month ago. Just, you know, I guess I'm a hopeless romantic kind of guy. Ballad. I guess between the two of us, I guess I write more ballads than anything else. You know, we think love is important. Alan writes about love in a general sense as well as ballads. I'm more of a ballad kind of guy. I don't know why. It's just the sensitive side of me, the Hallmark side of me. Hopefully, you guys like this one. Forgot to do the thumbs up. You're not gonna let me let that down.
Songs in this first set, and then we're going to take a little intermission so we can move some stuff around and fit people up here and whatnot. As I said, my name is Alan Sosa. He's a professional drumming. This is John Zavala and Marco Angel. John and I have been playing together since he came back from Marines and
about 16 years
old. Yeah, and so and then about 3 years ago, I started playing 4 years ago here, and then I did that for about a year, and then I realized I need someone to help me like play guitar. And John came a couple of times to sing some songs, and so it helped me though, because I asked him, hey, I need another guitarist who plays guitar exceptionally. I need a second person next to me, and so he started coming in, and we started getting together and gelling. Marco, this is his year anniversary, technically with us.
Welcome to the second half of the show. This is our last
gig of 2018, and we appreciate y'all coming out, taking your time to get out here tonight. And this next set, last year, 3 years ago, we started doing some Christmas songs and whatnot for this December, which is apropos. So. But, I wasn't sure. You'll remember it later and be like, man, that dude said that funny thing about the Christmas song. And so, anyhow, we started, last year we got together, like I said, and we started practicing it. We pretty much had one rehearsal like we did this year, because that's what we do. And so last year I was dealing with a lot of starting to have throat issues and whatnot, and so, Renee joined us, like I said, we've been friends since my senior year of high school, and a lot of fun adventures together over the years, and didn't get arrested, so that's
yeah.
Good.
Some of which I cringe thinking about.
That's right. That's the other good thing. There was no Snapchat back then because, you know, like if you wanted to video, you'd have to like take the video, make sure it's charged, make sure you film the camera. See, I don't have that problem. You just have it right there.
And by now, those videos are lost.
Yeah, they're all gone.
They're lost.
And
all the lost videos.
So, but yeah, so it's a silly thing. So, girl, she's going to join us on some singing and playing some percussion and whatnot. And so, anyhow, I'm glad y'all could be here. And the first song we're going to get started with is Please Come Home for Christmas. And John's going to be leading out with that.
Just as sure as the stars shine up above. this is live. You know it's there's no pre-recorded track. We just start.
You know I'm not lip-syncing now.
That's right.
That's why I didn't.
No Ashley Simpson joking around. It's all right. Last gig, we started into Corner Room Blues. Easy, nothing. I sat there for like 12 bars. No lyrics. They're just gone. They were just not there. I'm like looking over at them and like they're just playing and I'm like, I need to do a solo. And then finally, like, I just, like, started singing, like, my head, I had this other song, like, that's not it. I'm like, and so then finally, it was like the brain, like, the hamster, like, got back on the wheel and started spinning it. So,
I just thought you were trying something new.
That was what I was doing, age. All right. So then afterwards, we'd have like a nice little formal like dessert thing afterwards. And so I just remember, like, I had never done it with, other than with the choir people, kids. And like, I was so nervous because I thought, what if think I'm lewd or whatnot. But I thought, well, I'm just going to go with it and be lewd or whatever. So I got up there and I'm, you know, gyrating around and like, I remember like this, looking at this lady and she was like spellbound. And like, I'm like, oh gosh, like, you know, like, and I was super like, I was acting like Elvis, but me was like, oh my gosh, like this lady's making weird faces at me, what do I do? Oh my gosh, what does that mean? And so afterwards, I remember she came up to me and I'm like, pretty much like losing every ability. I didn't speak real well, as I said, I used to mumble a lot, but I remember like looking at this person, she's like, you are amazing in every way. And I'm like, thank you. Like, I just couldn't talk, I was disturbed. So anyhow, so we're gonna go to a version of this and see if we can remember all the words. I'll have a home. Get into optimal shape, so it would come back. But that was Marco Rangel, and the guitar for that one. He's doing double duty. Double the pay for that one. Double the pay. But, yeah, Renee's going to sing probably my favorite Christmas song of all time, and, yeah, it's just my favorite. I love the Judy Garland version is my favorite, Meet Me in St. Louis. If you have not seen that movie, young people. So you should watch that movie because, you know, it's wonderful. Great music. One time I posted that, I was like, on Facebook, you know, when I first got on, watching Meet Me in St. Louis, and like two of my friends like, dude, why don't you watch the Cowboys? I'm like, well, the Cowboys are losing, and this is making, like, I'm making me, and this is making me angry, this is making me happy. All right. Sitting in the audience, and if my kids are playing, they'll be like, my parents were so cool. I'll be like, Ninja, you don't say that. When I'm like, yeah, you were 14 and I was 42. Okay, I'm cool. All right, whatever. But I just would have really good conversations with them. And like I said, they were a second, you know, second mom and dad. that to me and everything. And he was a cool other younger sister. So Tony was ready. I also have as well, being the oldest of my family, so anyhow. So there, y'all mean a lot to me, and I'm glad that we still have this friendship for all the years. So that's a Hallmark movie moment for y'all. So the only original we're doing this set is a song I wrote about 4 years ago. And, well, I wrote the song lyrics, most of the song lyrics, almost probably like this Christmas of 1993. Like I didn't know how to play guitar at that point. I learned after graduating high school. A friend taught me 18 E's. If you play 18 E, you play any Buddy Holly song. And that for me was like, great, we got the promised land now. And then I bought a Beatles chord book and started teaching myself how to play, and then I started trying to write a song and going from there. And but I wrote these lyrics for this girl I was dating at the time, thinking she'd lie. I wrote this song and then I wrote this other song. Her name was Amber. But I wrote the song that I was really impressed with. It was called Won't You Come Home Nelly or whatever it was. It was not like, and I thought, oh, this is a beautiful romantic song, and she's like, why did you call it Nelly? I'm like, well, because it fit in this rhyme. Like, my name is not Nelly. I'm like, oh, yeah, that's true. Didn't think about that. So anyhow, so, yeah, that's right. I didn't count that much. So 23 years later, I decided I was in this songwriters group, and one of the phrases was Christmas, so I had found like a stack of like my old lyrics and stuff and poems, and half of them are vomit inducing. But this one I thought, well, I can do something with this and shape it. So anyhow, this song is called With Someone Like You Is Christmas. Every day is Christmas. So in the chorus there's a hey hey part, so you'll hear it. Feel free to sing along, or feel free to sing along to any of these songs. I mean, everybody knows them, and if you don't, then you can go home and learn them. But this one helps us out, alright?
Well, better yet, they're on our music page, so go check that out.
That's right.
Of music.
That's right. Facebook.
Yeah.
Thank you. All right. See, if I knew Lee was going, I would have had him bring his guitar, and then he could have played this next song with us, Chuck Berry's song. Next year, next year, you'll do the, I'll do the Elvis, the guy rating and stuff. You'll play the Chuck Berry guitar. You'll play the ukulele. Mandolin's too many strings.
Oh, yeah.
Four strings. And then we mastered the mandolin. Alrighty. Well, we're gonna do this Run Run Rudolph song. Thank you all for coming.
You're welcome.
Have a nice last day at school. Have a Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
I don't
know. Oh, no, they still have school.
Yeah, they go one more day.
Hey,
be good to start. Santa's watching. He grabs a chocolate too. You don't play. All right. Hey,
Santa.
Hey, Santa. Which I'm not too happy about, but I guess such as it is. I prefer the cold Christmas. Because after that, I'm like, we can get warm again.
Exactly.
There's no time for cold then. Yeah. So, we're going to keep on. This is probably my next favorite Christmas song. It's called Christmas Baby Please Come Home. It's the version I like by the great Darlene Love. So there's a... we'll do Feliz Navidad next. So we're going to rewind that. We're going to do Feliz Navidad next. That's just what we're going to do. Feliz Navidad. So we had to do Feliz Navidad.
This
Well, it wouldn't be Christmas without this song. It wouldn't be Christmas without Renee singing the song.
No one has ever heard this song before. Ever.
I think I remember driving with you. Did you have that blue Mustang?
Yeah.
And like
my very short
first car. and a friend borrowed it and then like skipped school and didn't come back and wrecked it.
Sad. I remember listening to the song and that song was a good memory. Not the crashing, the wreck.
He got me all mad before I happy song.
Happy, happy. Who knows, maybe you would have had your own
record. Maybe she's saying
that line. That's right. That's right. That's right. So we'll have one more after this one, and then we'll bid a good night. But don't leave before we say thank y'all. Thank y'all again for coming out tonight. And everything before we close, and so we have one more after this, but it means a lot to me, y'all support, even if this is your first time coming, or if you're 18,000 time coming, it all means a lot to us. This, you know, we do this for love, and for brotherhood, and sisterhood, and family, and for Yasmin as well, and she's here tonight, gracing us. So, she's been gone for a while, so, anyhow. But we're glad y'all can make it out tonight. It means a lot to us. So I hope this season brings you cheer. And if it's not, you know that you matter and that you're loved and you're cared for. It's just one person that means a lot. So anyhow, we'll keep going.
I don't know why I can't seem to start a song right tonight. Okay. I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my home. Marvin,
months off theology tonight, and do appreciate y'all's coming and whatnot. Last song we're going to do, John's going to sing. It's Happy Christmas, the war is over. The world is crazy today, and, you know, we could talk for hours about these things, but you know what? I think, you know, sometimes you just, all you can do is sing and let your song be your protest, meet your, let the love in your heart lead out for that, and just love more. I think that's what we need more than anything in this world. Well, thank you all for coming out. Like I said, don't leave before we can say hi. Thanks and everything. So, wish you all a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, whatever you guys do. I hope that it's a good season for everybody.
Just begun.
Thank you.
You too.
No, you should.
I was waiting for it.